I swear by Almighty God that the evidence I give shall be the truth.
I don't know who else to turn to.
He didn't mean to do it.
But my lord.
Justice.
I just want justice.
Justice.
This noble court will now convene in due and rightful solemnity. All rise for Julian Clare.
How kind, thank you. Welcome to All Rise. My name is Justice Julian. You remember Rump Pole of the Bailey? Well, I'm more rump than pole. Now, I expect you were wondering, as you came here this evening, why are we being strip-searched? Well, security has been tightened this evening, and as my dictum says, the tighter the better. I have to tell you that I've already found three men concealing offensive weapons. Not that I was offended. Thought it was Christmas, but talking of the festive season, here's a man so steeped in tradition, I frequently mistake him for a figgy pudding. It's the clerk of my court, Geoffrey Parker Knoll. Sausage, you.
I'm very well, my lord. Like a good Stilton, I improve with age.
Yeah. I'm more like a Marks and Spencer's Jersey dessert myself. I need eating by Thursday or I'll go off.
The analogy is very amusing.
Stop muttering, Geoffrey, and let's have the first case now, please.
Gawler, Bob Fever, Anne Ford, Jackie Lydon, and Jill Williams. Bob charges his three neighbours with coercion by making him enter the Croydon in Bloom competition for the third consecutive year, and he doesn't want to do it.
Okay, hello.
Hello.
Bob. You look like someone out of Dallas, I can't think who. Move up just half an inch. Now, better explain first of all, Croydon in Bloom, what's that?
Well, it's the flower contest we have each year.
A flower contest?
Yes. So we've got the hanging baskets thing. Of the flower boxes.
Flower boxes?
Put flowers in them and it's into the competition.
I see. And what happened the last 2 years?
Oh, we won. This is our magic thing. We won twice.
These are your certificates?
Yes, yeah.
Mr. Fever, Care for Croydon Award. It would make you want to commit suicide. Anyway, keeps you off the streets, doesn't it? I don't want them. No. Where exactly, Bob, is it that you live?
South Croydon.
Now, this is your house here. Look behind you.
Yes, it is.
That's your... Oh, it's a little sort
that's
of...
That's all my neighbour, though.
Your row, a row of terraces, isn't it?
That's right, yes.
Who's this witchy woman in black?
That's the one on the end.
So you happily entered the last 2 years. This year, what
I
didn't...
I just fed up with doing it. When I first moved in... I had a...
No, it's very funny. When I first moved...
Well, I invited my neighbours round.
When you moved into this charming, if modest, terrace.
Yes. Too bad.
How many bedrooms?
Front and back.
Which one do you sleep in?
Back.
I know what you're saying. Yes, we're going back to when you moved in 3 years ago.
I held a barbecue for all my neighbours, knocked on their doors, complete strangers to me, invited in my home, just to introduce myself and make us all friends.
Yeah?
And they all got on to me that time. They said, we must have this competition for all the hanging baskets, the flowers and so on. So being a nice neighbour, I just moved in and met everybody, I said yes. And that was 3 years ago and they just haven't let me off the hook since. Every year I've had to do this, go out, wash all the plants and the flowers twice a day, and it's cost me a lot of money and time and deadheading.
So this year you thought...
I've never deadheaded anything my life before.
You haven't lived. So this year, and you said, not going to do it anymore.
Quite right, yes.
And they're objecting.
Yes, they are. It'll be a terrible time.
Oh, excellent. Okay, well, I'll have a word.
Please
on
do.
Your behalf with these unscrupulous horticultural gangsters. Can I sit amongst you? Can I sit between the black and the primrose yellow? Now, who have we got? I know you've got names on your Anne.
Yeah.
And
Jill.
You're Jill, and you're the whip. No, you're Jackie. Very clever the way you've coordinated your lipstick with your crocheted top. I'm only saying she has. Who first had this idea for entering Croydon in bloom?
Well, someone knocked on the door and asked us to enter.
Was that before you had so much as a dandelion outside the front?
No, we had to wear baskets outside. And...
Yes, it's nice little terrace. And I suppose you need him to do it because he's right in the middle.
Yes, precisely.
Do you think the community appreciates your efforts?
Definitely. Very much,
yeah. Is there any word from the community, Geoffrey?
Yes, well, look, we have managed to capture the opinions of the populace of Croydon. Mm.
People that do the baskets in Wines Road have a beautiful display all summer long. Absolutely a delight to look at.
I know Vines Road, but I can't remember ever seeing any hanging baskets up there.
It would be quite unfortunate to have one mucky house in the middle.
Brennan, what did you just say about the people that live on Vines Road?
I think they're all arseholes.
You can't please everyone. If he doesn't want to do it, why should he?
He enjoys the adoration from it all.
Well, he's very proud of his certificates.
And the publicity.
Shove those under my nose.
He's always
finding
the local paper.
He doesn't do the baskets himself. He gets them done for him.
What do you mean?
Well,
goes out and buys them.
Buys them from the nursery.
Or buys them already made?
Yeah, he cheats.
Oh.
We make up all our own.
That's, you do it all your own, from seeds.
Well, not quite. But we haven't got a greenhouse, so we've gone a bit further than that. And
but do you actually stuff. Plant them and you get your hands dirty?
Yeah.
Excuse me, Bob, is this right?
Oh, dear, what?
I've seen those ready-made ones, and they're always too good to be true. Do you buy them already made?
I do. I buy one. I know how to do
and
things.
And you've got the nerve. Confiscate those. I've heard quite enough, Bob. I feel a verdict coming on.
Oh, dear.
The defendants will rise.
Beryl, stick those where the sun don't shine.
And four to Jackie Lydon and Jill Williams. You are severally charged with coercion at the Garden Centre.
Yes, and, you know, I've detected coercion. And collusion, and can I say non-specific urethritis? However, I've decided, in my wisdom, to find the three of you not guilty. You, however, up on your feet, Bob, up on your feet. It's a disgrace. I think... What are the recommended sentences for this kind of behaviour?
Why not bang him up?
Not in my nature.
Hang him!
Hang him, I will hang him. Hang him, I think, like his baskets. It's what the public want me to do. Who am I to refuse? Geoffrey, the black cap, please.
It's in the wash, my lord. I did a coloured load this morning.
Thought he had a spring in his step. Well, put him on death row then, or death muse as I prefer to call it, and may God have mercy on your soil, Bob. Take him away, Bob Fever, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, you're free to go. Oh, a snowball, Beryl. That's just what I fancy, thank you very much. This is Beryl, by the way, my court usher. Beryl, ever hopeful of being spotted by a BBC talent scout. What's next, Geoffrey?
Well, as you may recall, Your Lordship, the next case was held in camera earlier this week as it involved a minor.
Yeah, I remember the case. This was the mother who ruined his birthday party, didn't she, Geoffrey?
Would you care to review the videotaped recording?
I would care to do that very thing.
Indeed, so, Bernard. Master Lurdeson charges his mother, Inga, with breach of contract.
Yeah, she looks the type.
Kieran's birthday party was due to take place from 7 until 11 of the clock post-meridian. His mother peremptorily terminated the proceedings 30 minutes early.
Ooh. It's not on, is it, Kieran?
No.
So how old are you?
I'm 11.
And this was your 11th birthday party?
Yeah.
That you were planning. So you'd asked your mother if you could have a party, first of all.
Yeah.
And she said, okay.
Yep, she did.
And then what happened? You talked to me about it.
Well, all the guests got there. And,
You sent out invitations?
Yeah, I had. Stop there.
Oh, yes, so it is. And it says from 7 to 11?
Yeah.
That was by arrangement?
Yeah.
Okay, so your guests arrived. How many?
Seven.
Seven guests?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, as soon as they got in, they were all gathered in the kitchen. Mum said, no. She said she didn't want it till 11. She said it was too late, and she just changed it to 10:30.
What, on the spur of the moment?
Yeah, exactly. Same night, everything.
After, there wasn't anything untoward going on?
No, nothing.
Doesn't seem fair. She won't even look me in the eye, will she? And were you playing games? Were you dancing? Was there music?
Yeah, we were dancing upstairs. We had food and things like that. And shandy.
And shandy and all of that. Lovely. And so you brought your mother to court. Why?
Well, I don't think that was fair, changing the party on the spur of the moment.
No?
No.
Okay, well, I'll ask her why on earth. Why did you change the time of the party at the spur of the moment? Couldn't you have thought of this earlier? Please speak to me.
I changed the time because I was on my own, you see, with my son and his friends in their little skirts and their... And I thought, no, I can't sit here for over...
It's that kind of party, was it? Bring your own skirts.
Bring your own skirts.
Yeah, but they're only 11. What were they going to do that was worrying you?
Well, no. It was just the fact that I was on my own and I thought, you know, 4 hours is enough. 7, 8, 9... 3 hours is enough. 3 hours is enough.
I see, but you should... I mean, you just should have thought of that earlier, you know.
I should have done, but yeah. I didn't. And I'm the adult, and it was my decision. I gave him a party.
And then you took it away again.
I didn't take it away. I took half an hour away.
Well, it's breach of contract.
Is it?
Is. You'd let him send out these invitations saying, I mean, I'm under contract to the BBC. I can't say, oh, I tire of it and walk out now. No, that's not how life works.
Well, that's life in my house.
Yes.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Sitting there in a frosted pink lipstick.
There is something else.
Oh, there
Excuse
is something.
Excuse me, you're talking to
no,
me,
come,
aren't you?
Come over here, come over here. Move up a bit. He's interrupted with something else.
He has.
What was it?
Mum also promised me two videos.
Two? I didn't know about this. She promised two videos, yes.
She forgot them. And...
Do you remember this?
No, I don't remember a thing.
You might be making this up.
She promised.
You got any proof?
Well, no, but...
That's all right, you've got an honest face, yeah. I believe you. What else?
And,
two videos.
She said that girls could sleep over.
And then she changed her mind on that one.
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm. Well, I'm with you on that.
Well, I'm
there are neighbours.
There are neighbours.
You have to draw the line.
You have to draw the line somewhere, and I drew it.
Yeah, but the videos. You said you could have two videos.
What videos?
What videos?
You said I could have some videos, and then you told me you forgot them.
So we forgot the videos.
Well,
you.
Oh no. I've listened to both sides with great interest, and quite frankly, I feel a verdict coming upon me. Come back over to your doctor.
Silence in court. The defendant will rise. Inga Lurdeston, you are charged with breach of contract.
Certainly are. And I find you guilty, guilty, guilty. one of the worst cases I've ever had before me. Geoffrey, the revenge order, please.
Yes, my lord.
Thank you. I'm signing here. This gives you the right to embarrass your mother in front of her friends whenever you feel the urge. There'll be no appeal. Clear the docks. Thank you very much. Well, Geoffrey, as I always say, justice must always be seen to be done.
Oh, indeed, my lord. I believe, my lord, that Master Lariston is holding for you on the telephone.
Hi.
Oh, hello.
It's Kieran.
Kieran, I thought it might be. Just been watching you, and I've been informed that the revenge order has been served.
Yeah, it has.
Tell me how it went. What did you do?
Mum was planning a dinner party.
Who did you have round?
One of her friends from college. A Romanian friend.
Yes, we've all got one of those. Yes.
Well, Mum thought I was with my grandma that evening.
Right.
But I was with Huntley and Palmer.
Same difference.
Okay, so we arrived.
You arrived.
Yeah, we burst through the door.
Burst in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I showed Mum the revenge order.
Mm-hmm.
And I got Huntley and Palmer to take her up to her bedroom.
How did all the other guests react?
The Romanian one asked who you were.
Yes.
So I came upstairs and read her a goodnight story.
Got a taste of her own medicine, didn't she?
Yeah. I don't think that was enough, though.
What other kind of revenge do you have in mind?
Do you want me to tell you some embarrassing things about her?
Well, I can't. Seems to be a popular suggestion with the studio audience. Go on, then.
Okay, the majority speaks, okay?
only 11. Yeah.
Okay, we went on holiday to Mallorca.
Mm-hmm.
And, Mum just... It was getting hotter and hotter.
Yeah.
So Mum thought, well, she was down to her bra now. And she thought, well, I'll take it all off.
Yes.
She took all her clothes off.
Mm-hmm.
And she slept on the balcony, totally naked.
Oh, how embarrassing for you.
And it had the rails on the balcony were very far apart.
Yes.
So anyone could see. I think lots of people did.
So they were buying tickets, weren't they? Maybe, Kieran, you've embarrassed your mother enough now, do you think?
Yeah, I think so.
Could call it quits now, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Lovely. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I'll speak to you again sometime.
All right, then.
Bye-bye, Kieran.
Bye.
We'll say bye-bye to Kieran. Bye. Bye. Now... Ladies and gentlemen, my sack is bulging. I've been inundated with letters from the general public begging me to exile an irksome celeb to the back of beyond, and I'm going to satisfy you.
It's celebrities to the Hebrides.
Call Mr. Lionel Blair.
Thank you.
Lionel Blair, on this day you are charged with prostitution.
Not in those trousers, surely, Jeffrey.
I refer, my lord, to Mr. Blair's status as a dogged old trooper.
I know what you're saying. Dog-eared old trooper. Hello, Lionel. Put a face. Thanks.
Oh, you're
known in the business for someone who will do anything for 50 quid and a slice of fruitcake. Steady. You're charged, Lionel,
yes,
with filling the airwaves with your nonsense razzmatazz.
What?
I'm afraid, yes, you.
What?
It's time that you face the music.
And dance.
There may be trouble ahead. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance,
Come on, stretch your stump.
Music and dance.
No wonder. Let's face the music and dance.
Restrain that man. I feel a verdict coming on.
Lionel Blair, you are charged with prostitution.
And I'm afraid, Lionel, I have to find you guilty. Lionel Blair, you will be transported to this island here called St. Ivel in the Hebrides. There you will dwell for the rest of your finger-snapping, show-stopping days without recourse to tap shoes, sequins, or Grecian 2000. Get rid of him, please, now. Get rid of the old jitterbugger.
If you get rid of me, I promise you this. I won't dance.
Don't ask me.
I won't dance. Don't ask me.
How he ever got to be leader of the Labour Party, I'll never know. Tell me, we're coming up to the last case.
Yes, we are indeed, my lord. Call Jennifer Small and Dina Stevens. Dina Stevens charges Jennifer Small with abandonment. Oh. Dina claims that Jennifer ended their friendship when their singing partnership ended 14 years ago.
Tell me the story.
Well, we met each other when we were 7. We were very, very close. And we were doing some singing. My son was about 4. I decided at that time that I didn't really want to continue with the singing. And I told Jenny.
Were you singing professionally? Or were you singing as, was it a hobby or?
It started off as a hobby.
Okay. Were you a singing duo?
Yeah.
Called?
Sweet Harmony.
Sweet Harmony? Yes, and so you decided that you were busy with your child?
Yes, okay. And it was getting a bit hectic. I was missing him, so I decided I didn't want to really carry on anymore. I told Jenny this, and after a while, things just started to be a little bit difficult between us. Right. And then we really sort of drifted apart.
14 years ago.
Mm.
And have you made any attempts to patch things up in that time? Did you phone her up? Did you go and see her? Or?
I wrote a letter.
Okay.
To her, yes.
You wrote a letter.
I wrote a letter to her and
explaining
that there was difficulty in the friendship. There was no response, so I left it.
No response.
No.
And that's awful, really. But you missed her.
I missed her very much.
And
yes.
You still miss her?
Yes, very
and,
much.
And you'd
so.
Like things to be as they were. Okay, well, come over with me and we'll speak to your friend. Wasn't her yellow clothing you objected to? Jennifer, you're not being stroppy, are you?
No.
No, we're trying to sort this out, okay?
Okay.
And you still have feelings of resentment after all these years?
Not really resentment. I felt that we were going places musically.
Yeah, this is what it comes down to, I think. It was the sweet harmony.
That's right. I mean, we sounded pretty good together. Well, we sounded very good together, in actual fact. And then when I realised that she didn't actually want what I wanted, Julian, I just decided, well, I'm going to go it alone.
What did you do when you got the letter? Do you remember that?
I read it and I threw it away. But I just wanted to get back to where we were.
Yes.
But I didn't know. So many years had gone by. I thought, well, how do you make that move now? It's gone so long, you know.
Yes. Can I say the word pride?
Yeah.
Yes, I think yeah. I can. Now, what star sign are you, Dina?
I'm a Leo.
You're a Leo, and you are?
I'm a Leo, too.
You're also? Ah. Perhaps fate's taking control. Perhaps there's a clash there, maybe. I need some mystic advice, I think, from another sphere, Geoffrey.
I have the very thing, my lord.
Dina and Jennifer, the 14 years of your separation are over now,
You are both Leos. Your stars say you can be loyal, loving friends forever. Believe your heart's message and listen to Julian. Lean on him, but don't mess up his hair.
No. Mystic Meg, you know her hands are super glued to the table. Dina, pop back to your dock now, because I feel a verdict coming on.
The defendant will rise. Jennifer Small, you are charged with abandonment.
Yes, Jennifer, you are, but I don't feel any one person is to blame, really. So, Jennifer, I find you not guilty. Guilt would not be appropriate. You wouldn't want to be famous. No, take it from me. Oh, it's tiresome. Jenny, if I have one more sack of money dumped on my door, I'll come out in a rash. But in my infinite wisdom, yes, infinite, I've decided to sentence you both to a fantasy sequence. Dina and Jennifer, forward, please. Tonight, I'm going to give you the chance to fulfill your wildest dreams before an adoring BBC audience. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the return after 14 years of obscurity of Sweet Harmony.
Times in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. There's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. You just call me. You can call me.
Thank you very much, Jennifer and Dina. Thank you. Please don't forget, though, as they say in Lincoln's Inn, manipulatum genitalia in omnibus prohibitum. Good night. Thank you very much. Green fly in his stamen. Happened to me once.
Julian, Julian, thank God it's on the BBC.
Of course, I've worked them all, you know, Judy, Marlena, Larry, Viv, Bing, Bob, Mr. Blobby, Idi Amin.
Load of camp old nonsense from the BBC.